You, my friends, are a cave person. You're a caveman, you're a cavewoman. I don't care how many cars you have or where you shop at or what kind of clothes you wear. You are like biologically hardwired pretty much the same as your caveman ancestors. And so what you got to do is you got to think about how we got here. What did the caveman have to deal with, right? We've always heard about those stories of feast and famine. All right. There were times when there was very little food available. And then there was the summertime, like right now, when there was more food. Now, we have to consider, how did we make it through that famine? What type of survival mechanism was within our ancestors and is still within us that keeps us surviving? And so it's summer right now, and the days are long and the nights are short. Okay. And throughout history, there's been a lot of food available in the summer. And that summer was followed by the fall and the winter, where there was just a little bit of food, all right, and it was really cold. Now, how does our body deal with that? What's that hardwiring? What is that code within our body? How does it deal with that? Well, in the summertime, since the nights are so short, you have reduced production of melatonin, all right? And when melatonin is down, a few things happen. First off, your reproductivity goes up, all right? Estrogen goes up, testosterone goes up. That way, if you have enough fat on you and you become pregnant, then 9 months later in like April or May, when there's a lot of food available, you'll give birth, okay? The body's a trip, it's wild, all right? Secondly, you start to crave carbohydrates. Remember, summer, before we had refrigerators and freezers, was the only time where, you know, plants produced fruits and carbohydrates. And so the body craved carbohydrates, and the body also became more insulin resistant. So when we ate these carbohydrates, we converted them into fat. That way, when the famine came, we can live off of our fat stores. And then lastly, the body turned the extra sugar into cholesterol, because cholesterol actually reduces the freezing temperature of our cell membranes. That way we don't freeze in the wintertime. Okay, so we're more productive, we've got fat stores to use as food, and lastly, we're protecting ourselves from freezing, all right? Now, what's going on right now? Summer doesn't seem to end because of something called the light bulb. Like, we're all on this lunar cycle thing going on right now, okay? And you really can't shake it. We've got this light cycle, this dark cycle. We're really supposed to go to bed when the sun goes down, and then we wake up when the sun goes up. There were times throughout history when we would sleep like 13 hours a day. And then there was the invention of fire, and that shortened up a little bit. And then we have the light bulb, and now we're up all hours of the night, right? And we're sleep deprived, and we're sick. It's amazing when you look at the invention of the light bulb and how that correlates almost directly with the epidemics of diabetes and heart disease and cancers. You know, there's a food factor there, of course, but we're missing the other things like sleep and stress and whatnot. All right. And so since we never turn off our lights, our bodies always think that it's summer. It always thinks that the famine is coming, but it never does. And so we keep on storing this fat all the time, and then we just become sicker, all right? Because if the estrogen always stays up, then we're gonna get cancer, okay? If we're storing all this body fat, we're gonna get heart disease, we're gonna get diabetes, all right? And so we need to get to bed. I got some tips for you for this sleeping thing. Go to bed at 10 o'clock, wake up at 6. Okay, you don't have to stay up late to watch, you know, Letterman and Leno. Go to sleep, because, like I said, we're on a clock that we can't shake. Between 10 o'clock and 2 o'clock is our physical repair. Just between those hours is when our body will repair our joints, our muscles, our bones, right? Between 2 a.m. and 6 a.m. is our psychogenic repair, right? That's when we're rejuvenating, all right? Repairing our mental function, repairing our brain, repairing the hormonal systems. Okay, and so if you're still getting your 8 hours sleep, but your 8 hours sleep is from 2 a.m. to 10 a.m., then you're missing one of those repair cycles, all right? And maybe that's why you're tired all day. Maybe that's why you wake up feeling unrested, all right? Another thing is that when you get off of work and you go home and it's dark outside, don't turn on your full spectrum lighting, because it just makes your body go, whoa, daytime again, shut down melatonin, increase cortisol, put sugar into the bloodstream, increase insulin resistance, make you fat. And so it's the light bulb as well. It's not just the diet. It's a lot of other things too that we'll get into later on. And so follow those recommendations. Investigate this. Go to Mercola.com. He has some fantastic articles on sleep. Check out this book right here, Lights Out, Sleep, Sugar, and Survival. And that's by T.S. Wiley. Check that book out. It'll blow you away. All right? And check back next time on www.undergroundwellness.com. Check out the website. Come check out my next video on Thursday or Friday. And I'm going to holler at you guys later. Go to sleep.